Hey there, Bruce Kirkby with Starboard, and probably the most unusual location you could imagine for a tiki talk. But today I want to talk about Nordic double poling and what an extraordinary opportunity it provides paddleboarders for cross training in the off season. For those of you in northern climates or inaccessible to water right now, it reinforces like the fundamental core motion of a paddleboard stroke. And there's also a few little areas that you can focus on that I really think whether you're a beginner or an expert paddler will advance your stroke next summer. Paddleboarding technique is still evolving, and we're seeing whether you're following Connor, the way he sprints with a quick drop down and the butt back a little bit, Boothie with a perfectly balanced position, Larry Kane in the background of canoeing that has more of a rotational stroke. If you take all of the arms out of it and you simply look at the core position, all of those are fundamentally the same, where we have a stiffened spine and a gravity assisted hip hinge. This is a fundamental movement pattern, that hip hinge, that is powering the body forward. And that's what double poling is. 20 years ago, if you were watching elite level World Cup skiers, there was a lot of arm motion in this. And like paddleboarding, this has evolved. As we've learned, it's important to preferentially use the bigger muscles, the hips, the core, the glutes, instead of the arms. So I got an expert with us, Coach Tim, who is going to talk us through just the fundamentals of the new Nordic double pull.
I see a lot of people double pulling, and they're trying to use arms and extending through their arms, and that just translates to small muscle groups, triceps, stuff like that. And so we want to focus on that core engagement when we're double pulling, which then relates to paddleboarding, as you said. And so I often tell people, think of this as if you're planking, holding a plank. So a good posture through that upper body, and that core is engaged. You're not flexing the core so you can't breathe, but it's engaged so you can connect your whole body. And then with our arms, we want to think of them as an extension of our core. We're not trying to power through our arms. We're keeping them relatively close so that core is engaged. And I use the analogy of a rock. You're holding a rock up at head height, and you're trying to slam it in front of your toes as hard as you can. And so you're not just using arms to slam that rock down. You're going to use your whole body, and that energy or mass up top with engaged core transfers that force into our poles, which propels us forward.
I like to have my elbows just slightly wider than my hands. I don't want to be forcing them up, so just slightly wider than the hands. And then, like I mentioned before, they're an extension of our core. So that motion to get the core engaged is here. I'm not using my arms to pull. It's just T-Rex arms and getting up over top of those poles. I think a lot of with skiing is weight shift is really important, and people forget about shifting our weight forward. So I call it a glute drive. And so from a side angle here, is down here, and I need to drive my hip center of mass forward. And like you said, those World Cup skiers, Olympic skiers, they're so strong at driving that mass forward that they're actually getting up off the snow. So I don't like people to think about standing up on their toes, because then they stand up, but it's a matter of transferring our weight and that driving our hip center of mass forward, so that if our poles weren't there, we would literally fall on our face.
Now here's some of the great payoff that can come with Nordic double poling. First of all, you're training that repetitive hip hinge, and you can do 50K on this, you can do uphills, you can really get strong in the off season. But here's some of the fundamentals it reinforces. First of all, for paddlers, it's really hard to get the idea of putting their weight onto their paddle. They're pushing a paddle straight down into water. That's difficult to imagine. This allows us to do it in a safe environment. We're loading our poles and we can hold them there. We couldn't do this on the water, and it teaches you to really load your paddle with your body weight as you come forward. The next thing it helps with is the catch. There was a time when Nordic ski coaches were talking about slamming the poles down into the ground. That has become more nuanced. And just like the catch, there's this really delicate moment between when the blade's in the water, fully buried, or when the tip of the pole is on the ground. And then, just as that happens, we apply the power sharply and abruptly. We want to put the most of our push right into the very start of the poling motion, just like we want to put the most of the power into the very start of our paddling motion. The other thing that this helps us with is the concept in paddleboarding. We're always talking about you want to plant the pole in you plant your blade in the water and cement it there and pull yourself past it rather than pulling the blade through the water. Obviously, we can really get a sense of that with Nordic double pulling because the pole ain't gonna move. And so you're able to feel your feet be pulled past those two planted poles. And it really gives you a sense physically, proprioception wise, of what you're trying to accomplish with your paddling technique. I hope all of that helps. This is an amazing way to get strong for the upcoming season. If you're in a northern climate or if you're away from water, please throw any comments, any questions, any ideas in there. I think we're gonna have an ongoing discussion about this. I'd love you to be involved. Let me know what you think, and we'll see you out on the trails and then out on the water soon.